Good day, students. Welcome to clip number 9 on our review series of mathematical induction. Remember, a collection of clips can be found on mathgotserved.com on the pre-calc. So before we take a look at the problem in this review installment, let's write down, review our plan of attack, okay? So let's write down the plan that we're going to use to carry out our proof by induction. So we're going to break it into three steps. Step number one, we have the base case, okay? So base case, for the base case, what we're going to do is we're going to show that a statement is true for the initial condition where the set of natural numbers satisfy the equation. Okay, so in this problem, we have the set of natural numbers. So the smallest natural number is one. So for base case, we're gonna show that n equals 1 is true. It doesn't always start from 1. Sometimes it might be 2, 3, whatever. But for in the case of this problem, we are dealing with a whole set of natural numbers, so we start with 1, okay? Number 2, we have the inductive hypothesis. Inductive hypothesis is the second part of our proof. For inductive hypothesis, we're going to make an assumption. We're going to assume that n equals k is true. N equals k is true for some k instead of natural numbers. Okay, so assume that n equals k is true for some k in a set of natural numbers. Okay, and then the third portion, which is the longest and most complicated, is the inductive step. Inductive step. So for inductive step, we have to show that n equals k is true by assumption implies that the next step, n equals k plus 1, is also true. All right, so this is our plan of attack right here. That we're going to use to go ahead and do the proof. All right, so let's take a look at the problem. 9, we are to prove that 9 to the n minus 2 to the n is divisible by 7 for all and in the set of natural numbers. Okay, now another way of phrasing this question is they asked to prove that 7 divides 9 to the n minus 2 to the n. Same thing, okay? So this is an English statement. In order to do my proof, I want to write this in a mathematical form. How do you express divisibility using an equation? All right, so how I like to define it, this statement in mathematical form, I'm going to write S of n, the statement that 9 to the n minus 2 to the n is divisible by 7 can be written by 9 to the n minus 2 to the n equals 7m for some m in the set of natural numbers, okay? So the reality of the case is if you can write any number as 7 times an integer, then that number is divisible by 7 because when you divide both sides by 7, you'll be left with that integer on the right side, okay? Or you can neatly factor out 7 from that number. Okay, so this is the statement that we're going to be using to carry out our proof, all right? So let's start out with part 1. Part 1, remember, is the base case from our plan. For base case, what are we going to do here again? Let's refresh our memory. For base case, we're going to show that n equals 1 is true, okay? Why did we start from 1? Because in a set of natural numbers, the first or the smallest number is 1. Now, how do we show that? Well, that's easy. We just take this statement right here, and we're going to plug in 1. So we're going to take a look at S of 1. S of 1 is going to be 9 to the first power minus 2 to the first power. 9 to the first power minus 2 to the first power is 9 minus 2, which is equal to 7. And we can write 7 as 7 times 1, which is equal to 7m for m equals 1. So the integer that satisfies this equation right here is the value where m is equal to 1. Okay, so 7 times 1 is divisible by 7 because you can write it in a form 7 times an integer. In this case, m is equal to 1. So what does this show? It shows that our base case is solid. Now, number 2, we're going to look at the inductive hypothesis. Okay, inductive hypothesis. We're going to be making an assumption here. Inductive hypothesis. But in inductive hypothesis, we're going to assume that n equals k is true. All right? So how do we make that assumption? We're going to take the statement and we're going to make n k and assume that that's true. All right? So let's go ahead and do that. So we're going to state a statement s of k, which means we're going to have 9 to the k minus 2 to the k is equal to 7m. We're going to say that this statement is true for some k and m in the set of natural numbers. Okay? So this is our assumption right here. And what this statement basically means is that, make a remark here. This means that 9 to the k minus 2 to the k is what? Is divisible by 7. So please don't forget, that's what this statement I just wrote here means. All right, next part 3 is our inductive step. Inductive step. For inductive step, we're going to show that n equals k is true by assumption implies that the next step, n equals k plus 1, is also true. If we can show this, then we can conclude by induction that the statement is in fact correct, or is the statement is always true. All right? So let's go ahead. We're going to start with s sub k plus 1. That's the next step after s sub k. And s sub k plus 1 is going to be 9. Instead of n, we're going to replace n with k plus 1 minus 2 to the k plus 1. Now we're going to make use of some properties of exponents here. Now you remember when we're dealing with properties of exponents, remember the product property? We have a to the x times a to the y. What is that? That is equal to a to the x plus y, right? You add the powers when you multiply an exponents of the same base. So this follows that a to the x plus y can be broken down into the same base, but they will have the power of the addends, right? So the power of the numbers you add in, so a to the x times a to the y. So it's basically the reverse of the product property of exponents. So you see the sum of exponents here? So I can basically write this base twice and associate this two numbers you're adding together with each base. Okay, so let's see what that looks like. We're gonna have 9 to the k plus 1 is the same thing as 9 to the k times 9. Okay, take that out of there. 9 to the k times 9. If you want, you can put the power. It doesn't really make any difference. 9 to the first power. And then the same story here, 2 to the k times 2 to the first power, using the properties of exponents as we illustrated here. Okay, now we're going to be making a substitution. Now, from our assumption, we know that, let's give this a number. Let's call this equation, call this 1. Now, we know from our assumption, since s sub k is true from part 2, our assumption, what can we say? Since s sub k is true, we know that 9 to the k minus 2 to the k is equal to 7m, right? For some k and m in n. Now, how about I add 2 to the k to both sides? If I do that, I'll have 9 to the k is equal to 7m plus 2 to the k. Okay? So let's call this, well, how about with these alphabets here? So let's call this A and call this B, since I already made these a 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to make a substitution. All right, let's go back here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to substitute 7m plus 2 to the k for 9 to the k in statement A. Okay, so let's rewrite what we had here. So here we had 9 to the k times 9 to the 1, which is just 9, minus 2 to the k times 2. Okay, this is from A right here. So now we're going to make a substitution. I'm going to take out 9 to the k and replace it with 7m plus 2k that we got from the assumption. All right, so let's see what that looks like. We're going to have, let me change the color so you can see what's happening. 7m plus 2 to the k. That multiplied by what? Let's see, by 9 minus 2 to the k times 2. All right, so what we just did is I took this entire expression, right here, and I plugged it in for 9 to the k. Okay, let me highlight it so you see what's happening. So this that we got from the assumption, I'm gonna take it and put it right here. That's what I did. All right, so with that, let's go ahead and do some manipulation and see if we can get 7 factored out of this expression. So we're going to have, we're going to basically distribute 9, right? So distribute 9, we have 9 times 7m plus 9 times 2 to the k minus 2 to the k times 2. All right? So if you look at these two last terms, notice that 2 to the k is common. I have a 2 to the k here and I have a 2 to the k here. So what can I do? Let's see. 9 times 7 is 63. So 63m plus, if you factor out 2 to the k, what will you be left with? You'd be left with 9 minus 2. All right, so simplify that further. We're going to have 63m plus 2 to the k times 7. Now, guess what? I can factor out 7 from these two numbers. So I'm going to have 7 times 9m plus 2 to the k. Right? So this m is an integer, k is an integer. So this entire expression right here is an integer. Let's give it a letter, okay? So let 9m plus 2 to the k equals L for some L in the set of natural numbers, okay? All right, so let's say that, assume that that's the case. So now what we can do, we can rewrite the original expression that we had, which was 9 to the k plus 1 minus 2 to the k plus 1 is equal to 7L. So what does this mean? This clearly shows that the next step, 9 to the k plus 1 minus 2 to the k plus 1, is divisible by 7 since you can write it as 7 times some integer. Okay, so this basically implies that 9 to the k plus 1 minus 2 to the k plus 1 is divisible by 7 since I can write it in the form 7 times some integer L. Okay? All right, let's go ahead and write our conclusion. Since the statement SN, the statement is true for the base case for n equals 1, and truth for an arbitrary k, n equals k, implies that the next step is true, implied that n equals k plus 1 is also true. Then the statement is true for all n in the set of natural numbers. Okay, my n kind of looks weird, but anyway, so that basically completes our proof, and then we'll draw our nice little box of accomplishments since we're done. So thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. We really appreciate it. Do subscribe to our channel for updates to other great clips such as this. And do post a comment to let us know what you think about this presentation. More clips can be found on mathgotserved.com. Thanks again for watching and have a wonderful day.